In this video, we'll take a look at how to use the brand new stability node in Silhouette 2023 to help you with the paints and comp work. If you've never opened Silhouette before, don't be intimidated, as this should be a fairly straightforward workflow. So just follow along with me and let's get started. The biggest benefit of using stability inside Silhouette is that it's pretty easy to use. Let's say you're a video editor. You finished your edit, and then suddenly, clients asks you, like, hey, can we remove that thing in the background? And you might have no paint experience at all. But if you're a Boris FX suit user, you shouldn't be scared by that. All you need to do is search for Silhouette Effect in your plugins list, apply that over your clip, and follow the simple workflow. Let me give you a walkthrough through the whole process. When you first launch the plugin, you may find a simple node tree already pre-created. Let's follow that. The first node is Roto, so I click on that and then go into my tools and select Explain tool. I need to draw two simple shapes around my object that I want to remove. You shouldn't be very precise. The simple garbage mask like this would work just fine. The first one is ready, now we need to draw a second one. So I click on the Explain tool again and draw my second mask. Something like this. Great. Now I would assign both of these shapes to the one layer and call that light stance. The next step is tracking. So I follow into the track menu and I would use Mocha Planner Tracker. My layer is selected so I can click track forwards. Alright, looks good. We have way through. Now we can move on to the actual cleanup. The next node by default is paint. But repetitive patterns like this brick wall may be really hard to work with, especially for beginners, as you need to be very precise where are you cloning from and all lines should be aligned. So instead of using paint, let's see how AI can help us. I would delete the paint node and add stability node. But here is the thing that I need to mention before we continue. In order to actually use Stability Node, you need to have your Dream Studio account and your API key. Once you register, you will receive some amount of free credits, but each image generation will use up some of them, so you will need to top up after you run out. To find your API key, you need to go into your account settings and copy it right from here. Then, inside your Silhouette preferences, go to the Machine Learning tab and paste your key in appropriate field. Now that is clear, let's get back to work. Inside Stability node, I would switch the mode from Generate to the Inpaint, and the model has been automatically switched to the Stable Diffusion Inpaint V2. There is a prompt field, but I would leave that blank for now. The only setting I would change is number of images. Instead of generating 4, I would turn that down to 2 to save some time and credits. And now we're ready to generate. We should wait a few seconds for the process to complete. And boom, our perfect pattern has been generated. You can swap between images to see what you like the most. I think the second one looks a bit better, so I would leave that. The only thing we'll have to do is to merge this image with the original source footage. Because we already did the track in our Roto node, that would be super simple. I would create transform node. Connect the yellow data port to the yellow output of the Roto node, and inside Transform settings, choose the layer that has the track information. This is our layer Light Stance. Now if I scroll through the timeline, I can see that the image is moving. Next step is to create a composite node and combine the results together. So I hit Tab on my keyboard and search for composite node. The first input should go into our plate, and the second one to our background layer. We also need to connect the output. And lastly, I would connect my blue matte input to our Roto node up here. Then inside node parameters, I need to turn on Obey. That way, images would be combined only in that area where we drew our shapes in the first place. If this edge looks too hard for you, now you can go back to the Roto node and adjust the feathering of the shape by using the handles, or hit Ctrl A to select all of the points, and then hit E a couple of times to add feathering to all of the points. Now let's check out our final result. and we are basically done. And that took no more than 2 minutes to complete. Alright, that was for the inpainting. But what's about the generate mode, and when would we want to use that one? Let me show it on another example. So we have a lady, she drinks some kind of potion, and then something weird starts to happen. She touches her face and starts to insanely scream at her reflection. The scene looks good overall, but with the help of silhouette and stability, we can emphasize it and make it look even more scary. So I have a couple of ideas what do I want to add here. We won't be working with the whole shot, so I selected only the middle section where she touches the face and scream. And as you may see, I already did some preparation work with tracking, so this video won't take a couple of hours and will be focusing only on the stability part. So let me quickly show you what I did inside Mocha. I used PowerMesh to track parts of your face like forehead and both of your cheeks, and that looks something like this. And then I exported the data into separate roto nodes. So this one has all of the meshes, and this one contains alpha for the cheek. And what do I need this for? One of the things that I wanna add is a creepy texture on her skin that will slowly crawl and fill her whole face and the neck. And to get the texture, I will use stability. I would leave the mode on generate, but I would switch the model to 105 because this is the one that I prefer. Now let's come up with our prompt. Let's try something like skin cracks photoreal 4K texture. Now, you may ask, why not just use the inpaint mode again? The reason is that we cannot use the inpaint for this kind of tasks, because A, stability will generate only one static frame, and B, if I try to inpaint her whole face, her appearance will just change too much, and even may look like a whole another person. That's not gonna work for us. So it is much easier for me to just generate the texture, and then composite it on top with the help of Mocha's power mesh. I switch it back to generate, disconnect it from the roto node, and try to generate again. And after a couple of tries, here's what I get. The thing is, what I was originally expecting to get is something like this, but instead, when I saw this one, I thought that it looks much more interesting and more detailed, so I picked this one. To blend that with the skin, I would use matte composite. The difference between matte composite and the regular composite is that this one has blending modes. You can use the mouse wheel to quickly go through all of them and pick the one you like. I would go with simple overlay mode. Now I need to figure out the placement, color, and the mesh warp. I used transform node to first roughly position my texture, then added an invert and color correction nodes to adjust the brightness, and also added just a little bit of blur, with the value of 1. Now it's time for a power mesh. So I create a power mesh node and connect that to the roto node that contains the mesh data from the Mocha. That's the one that I show you in the beginning. Then select the needed mesh layer. And now if I scroll back, you can see that the texture is warping. When we blend it with the source, here's how it looks like. Let's also connect the alpha for the cheek that we have up here. We can reposition the texture in case we want to. Okay, the texture on the cheek looks good, but it is visible through the whole range of the shot, and I want it to slowly reveal. The simple way to do that would be to just animate the opacity inside the composite node. So you can put a keyframe with the value of 0 somewhere in the beginning, and another keyframe in the middle of the shot with the value of, my case, 70. And now if I play it back, the texture is slowly revealing. But if you want to take that one step further, the other way of doing that would be to create a fractal noise, animate the lift parameter so it will go from completely black to normal, and use that as a revealing mat. To do that, you would need to multiply the alpha from the fractal noise with the alpha for the cheek. And that can be done with the alpha composite node. I connect the first input to the power mesh. Second one goes to the cheek alpha, and inside node parameters, I select multiply. Now I can feed all of that into the matte composite. By doing it that way, the texture revealing will look just a bit more natural. But if that sounds too complicated for you, the animated opacity will work just fine. I added a few more power meshes and repeated the same process for all of the other parts of the face, by using the exact same texture. I rendered the result so we can continue work on the shot, but it will be a bit easier for my laptop to play back. And this is how it looks like. I also added a large crack element to the mirror, but I will skip this part, as Nick Haraz has just recently made a whole other video on how to do a mirror crack effect. So go check it out if you want to see that technique in detail. Alright, let's add some more stuff to the shot. Because this scene is expected to be happening in some weird place, like a Witcher house or Abaddon's attic, this mirror looks a bit off. It is just too clean. And I want to make it look like it was standing there for years. So why not to try to generate some more textures and make things a bit dirtier? I added two more stability nodes, and my prompt for the one was grunge texture photoreal 4K. And for the other one, scratches texture on the black background. Both work out pretty well, so all I left to do is to merge that with the matte composite, add a decent amount of feathering, and add a brief touch of green tint. So far, here is my before and after. And that's the end of the first part, where we utilize the power of stability to comp our shot and speed up our workflow. Join me in the next video to see how to finalize the scene and dive deep into the grain management. If you want to see more silhouette tutorials like this, give us a like and leave a comment. Follow to BorisFX.com to learn about other suit products. My name is Elizabeth Postol. See you in the next videos.